everybody. This is Dee from Dee's Creative Hands Crochet. I'm just using my crazy hair and all that. I've been out running errands today. So, I was in Granny Dee's live today. Well, I was watching before I left and commenting whatever. And then as I got further and further, I couldn't comment or whatever. But as I got further and further away, I kept losing the signal and all that kind of stuff. So it was a nightmare trying to keep up with that. So I apologize, Granny Dee, if you're watching. I've got a couple things I want to tell y'all. Any comments in the live that I miss, you can always email me if you have a question or, you know, anything like that. Just shoot me an email because I was having a hard time keeping up. And I had to go back and look over everything to make sure I caught all the super chats and all that kind of stuff. So I just want to make sure, you're getting your questions answered if you need an answer. Also, too, I want to show you I started my great-grandson's baby blanket. And, well, this is what it's looking like. Oops, I'm dropping my hook and everything else. This is what it's looking like. Isn't that pretty colors? I like those colors. Okay, it is ice cream roving divagation. Divagation. Okay, this is the ball band. It is called Cool Blue. 437 yards per ball. It's a 4-weight. Requires a 6.5 millimeter hook. Machine wash warm, gentle cycle, tumble dry normal, medium heat. Don't you like to hear that? Yeah, you can wash and dry it. That's awesome. And like I said, it's called Cool Blue. Anyways, I'm just doing, half double crochets. I figure I'm going to do something fancy around the edges or whatever. But I just wanted to try out this yarn first because I've never used it before. And I got it during, I guess it was National Ice Cream Day or something from Lion Brand. And I got 40% off all the ice cream yarn that I bought in that one haul I showed y'all. Anyways, so I started working on this because the baby shower's next month. And I started working on this, and I thought, you know what? I want to tell you guys what I think about this yarn. Okay, first of all, I got the hair. You know, I always get the hair. It's from the fans. They move my hair around, and my hair's fuzzy. This yarn slides on the hook. I mean, you can crochet fast with this. But let me tell you, it's a little bit fuzzy. Okay, let me show you. I'm at the end of my skein. But can you see that fuzz on there? And y'all know what I'm talking about if you've worked a fuzzy yarn before. And see the halo? I think you can see it. My nails look terrible. Don't look at them. Anyways, it's getting tangled on itself quite a bit when I pull out the center. I've had a lot of yarn barf. I got a second ball ready to go, but I had to have Mark sit and untangle it for me while I'm in here because I pulled out yarn barf and it was all stuck on itself. And it's one of those ones where you got to break the fibers loose, you know. So I just want you to be aware of that. I've never used it before, so I thought I'd kind of give you my take on it. Beautiful yarn, super soft, slides off the hook like no tomorrow. But it does have moments when you're wanting to cuss at it. I just want to tell you. Yeah, there's a couple tense moments today with this yarn. And I haven't tried frogging it, but I'm going to guess that it probably gets hung up when you frog. You know, when you rip it back. I'm going to say that those fibers probably give you a hard time. Maybe not all, really super hard like some yarns are. But there's going to be moments when you're going to have to bring out scissors or you're going to have to bring out a needle to pick it out. And I hate when that happens. I don't know about y'all, but that just irks me when it comes to yarn. It's like, my gosh, as much as we pay for yarn. Okay, where did my other... There it is. Oh. Anyways, I just wanted to give you my take on it in case you haven't tried it before. Because I never have up until today. And like I said, I like it. you know, I'm gonna, I'll give it, you know, a thumbs up and all, but it's a little bit aggravating when it gets tangled because it's usually one fiber that's tangled around another piece of yarn. You have to dig it out or cut it or whatever. And, you know, I just don't want to mess with it like that, you know? And, but it's very soft. I mean, this is like super soft. This is baby soft for sure. And, I mean, the stitch definition is really good too. Can you see? Really good stuff. Oh, stuff definition. Oh, man. Stitch definition. But real good stitch definition. Super soft. Slides off the needle. But there's those moments when you, you know, you're screaming at it like, in your head, you know. You don't want people thinking you're nuts. But anyways, yeah. So that's my take on that yarn. You know, I've worked with other fuzzy yarns that have hung up, and I get so aggravated with those sometimes because, you know, we're all not all perfect, and we do have to frog occasionally, right? So, you know, if you don't like dealing with it, I'm going to tell you that that yarn hangs up on itself, in a nutshell. Okay, but like I said, it's super soft, glides off the needle, beautiful. I love the way the stripes form. Other than that, it's awesome yarn. So, you know, maybe you would want to, you know, give it a shot. I also finished my bodge shawl. This is the post-virus shawl. Now, I got about halfway done and ran out of this very glittery. It's got sequins. It's also got the metallic thread going through it. Love it. But it's very expensive yarn, this yarn. Okay, it's made in Italy or some fancy thing, and I got it on clearance. And when it came down to it, I couldn't find it anywhere. Finally, Mark found it. So this sat around being a whip for a couple of weeks when I would have finished it. Well, he got me 3 balls of it. And I told him, I think I only need 1 or 2. And he said, well, I'll get you 3 just in case. Well, he got me 3. This is not cheap yarn. For, you know, one of those little balls about that big, it was $13.95, which he freaked out about. And I said, the sticker on the ones that I have say $14.99. So actually, you got it a buck cheaper than it actually was if we would have had to go to the store and buy it. So, you know, that's still a lot of dang money. Well, anyways, he bought me 3 of them, thinking he gave me more than enough. Well, I ran out again. So the very bottom of the shawl, see, there's one of my hairs. Left some DNA in there. The very end of the shawl, you're supposed to do 3 rows of this virus stitch. I was only able to do 2. I did have a little bit left in a ball. Let me have brought it back in here. But not enough to do a full, you know, a full round of virus stitches. Because, you know, that's 1, 2, 3. The 3, 4 rows, just, yeah, 4, 5, I don't know, several rows. I can't think right now. Several rows just to make up, you know, 1 round with this virus stitch. So I only did 2 in the last round, and then I used the other yarn for the picot stitch. You know, the picots that are on there. So although it's very pretty, I would have liked to, I was hoping, you know, okay, I got 3 balls. Maybe I can do, you know, I over all the time underestimate how much yarn I need. It happens to me constantly. You think I would know better by now, but I don't. I don't follow a whole lot of patterns. And when I do, I don't think I pay attention to yardage. You know, I just assume, well, I got so much yarn, I'm sure I've got enough to do it, you know. Or I can mix this with this or whatever. And it's happened to me a couple of times that I have actually ran out of the yarn and it was hard to find and I couldn't get it and whatever. So, word to the wise, you want to pay attention to that yardage when you're doing a pattern. I didn't. And kind of regretted it because it ended up having to buy 3 more balls and then I ran out again. So the shawl is missing 1 whole row of virus stitches that I would have liked to put in there. So, and I would have liked to even gone 1 more 3 row block of the virus stitch because I would have liked it to be even longer. But anyways, this is the outcome of it. turned out really pretty. I like it. I'm not a huge pink fan, but this yarn is just so beautiful. I mean, even where the post stitches are, if you can see the sequence. Yeah, you can see it a little bit in this light. And then this, of course, has the sequence and the metallic thread. So it's real glitzy and shiny and all that kind of stuff. And what I was thinking about doing, me and Yarn Barf Christy were just talking about this. She had made a shawl, and she did that lacing that I did on that shirt that I just made. And she did the lacing right here in the front on her shawl. So it made it like a two-point poncho. And I said, you know what, I was just thinking about doing that to my bod shawl. Because honestly, I don't ever wear shawls. Ponchos I wear, but shawls I don't. And although pink isn't my color, I really kind of like this. I think it turned out really pretty. Let me turn around so you can see the back. But it ended up turning out pretty. And I like it. I wish I would have ran out of this yarn, because it was only like $8 or $9 a ball, opposed to the $14.99 ball. So, but hey, you live and learn. You know, one of these days I'll get this yardage business straightened out. Okay, sorry about that. You're talking to my belly. Okay, so I got the, I showed you my whip. I showed you my finished object, and I lost that sticky note again. Where does it keep going? There it is. This fan up here. Okay, sorry guys. All right, so I did that. I told you guys to, you know, write me an email. You know, if you got any questions that I didn't address in the live, because that's a, you know, that was my first one by myself. It was really, really hard for me to keep up. And evidently, that's just the way they are. So I guess I got to get used to it, or, you know, put on some big girl pants, something. Okay. All right, let me see. This is the 10 yarny questions, or 9, actually. Family Feud Yarny Style, that Ray's Yarn Addiction, I'll put a link for her channel, she's awesome, I love her, she's so sweet, tagged me in, and I thought I'd come on here and answer these. I always like doing these. I think they're a good way for me to get to know you by your comments, and you to get me by my answers. And, you know, if you already know this information, no big deal, you know, it's 2 minutes of your life, right? Okay, let me take a drink and we'll start reading this. Okay, number one, something you hate to find in your yarn. A knot, a split, that mess that I was dealing with it with that. That's the stuff I don't like to find in my yarn. I mean, what else are you going to find in your yarn? You know, bugs and rodents and stuff. Well, nobody wants to find that in their yarn. But I really hate snags and knots and all that. I just, man, you pay, like I said, you pay a lot for yarn now, especially now. They just upped everything. You know, so, you know, yarn companies need to get it together. We don't want to see knots. Especially, you know, like the Caron cakes and all that are $11.99, $12.99 now. $13. Okay, let's round it up by that penny. $13 for a cake of yarn. You shouldn't have knots in it. That's my opinion. Okay, number two. Something you do for your significant other when they buy you yarn. Buy him yarn. It's pretty much how it goes around here. We buy each other yarn. Something you snack on while crocheting and knitting. I don't like to have food around my yarn. But sometimes when I'm watching TV, maybe pretzels or crackers or something. Like I said, I really don't like to have food around my yarn. I don't want it getting all over my project. So, but I do drink a lot of Diet Pepsi. That's for sure. 24/7 after coffee. Okay. Any item found? Oh, name an item found in your yarn bag. Usually a lifesaver. Yeah, there's a snack, I guess. You know, a lifesaver or... like one of those hard candies that taste like coffee. I like those. Those you'll usually find one or the other, you know, something along those lines in the bottom of my crochet bag. Name. Okay. What do you drink while... I can't even read my own handwriting. That's pretty sad. What you drink while you crochet? I just answered that, I guess. Or knit. Diet Pepsi. What do I watch while I crochet or knit? Well, I only crochet, I don't knit. You know, usually whatever Netflix thing. Honestly, I like to just sit at my kitchen table and crochet and glance up at YouTube, and I'm good with that. But in the late evening, I'm usually on the recliners with Mark watching some Netflix series we've been catching up on or binge watching or whatever, and crocheting. So something on Netflix or Prime that I'm binge watching, or YouTube, mainly YouTube. Name a sport that you love to watch or play. Okay, I don't play sports. I'm not running. I'm not built for speed. Nope. I've never been athletic. This wasn't my thing. But when I was a kid, I used to love to ride my bike. I used to love to jump on a pogo stick, play jump rope, you know, all of those kinds of things. But I never thought of it as exercise or a sport or whatever. But that's pretty much about it for me. My grandfather pitched for the Tigers, the Detroit Tigers, back in the late 30s, excuse me. Back in the late 30s, early 40s. And so if I'm forced to watch a sport, baseball, because, you know, we're a baseball family. I used to like to watch hockey. Haven't watched it in years. I don't understand football. Okay. My daughter-in-law is like one of those people that can quote stats and who's on what team and who's being traded. I mean, she's one of those girls. She will yell at the boys to get out of the way of the TV so she can see the football games. And she's like that about basketball too, but more about football. And they're a football family. The boys play football. My son coach football. She's a, you know, sideline mom. You know, that kind of thing. They're really into the sports thing. But not me. I don't even understand football. Okay, number 8. Name a fruit that isn't round. Banana? I don't know. Banana? Name something you crochet. Wait. Oh, I'm getting this wrong. It says, name something you crochet or knit. Okay, I think I got that wrong. Oh, for Christmas or holidays you celebrate. Oh, Christmas, you know, a lot of different stuff. Sweaters and ponchos and scarves and hats and, you know, all that kind of stuff. Me and Mark spent several days making hats on the Addy and scarves. We made some scarves on the Addy too. And that's something. My mom is always hot. So, I got a hair tie on my wrist. Too tight, as a matter of fact. My mom is always hot. And she lives in a senior building, and she lives on the fourth floor. So, heat rises. So, she's in the middle of winter, has got her windows open. So, you know, I crocheted her blanket, and I've never seen her use it. Sitting in a corner. I made her a shawl. She's never used it. You know, anything I make for my mom is too hot for her. You know, it's just too hot. She's hot. Her building's hot. Whatever. So that's about it. You know, we did a lot of Addy machine hats and, you know, I don't know. I think I'm going to make dish rags and, you know, dishcloths and dish rags and scrubby sets or something. Mix it up a little bit. But that's only for the girls. I don't know what I'll do for the boys, for the guys. I don't know. I'll figure it out. But anyways, that's what I normally do. But hopefully I'm going to be able to switch it up this year. I don't want to give the same stuff over and over again. I thought there was a 10, but I've only written down 9. And I want to thank Ray's Yarn Addiction. Again, I'll put her link in the description box for tagging me in this. And let's see. I would like to tag Connie at Just Another Stitch. Hi, Connie. She's one of my YouTube buds. Let's see. I don't know if Crystal's done this or not. I was trying to think. Crystal, the yarny chicken crazy cat lady. She's my best yarny friend, my BYF. And I'd like to tag her, and I'll put her link in the description below. Let's throw a wild card in there. How about Nancy from She's Got Yarn Too? I like to watch Nancy. Okay, so I'll put everybody's channel links in the description box. And those are my questions. And I probably got some of them wrong. So that's the way it runs, I guess. Okay, let me see. I got some things coming up I want to tell you about. But I think I'm going to throw a giveaway in here. Nothing fancy. This is going to be a worldwide giveaway. All the rules and everything's in the box below. Description box down there. YouTube is not responsible in any kind of way. Me and Mark bought everything in the giveaway with our own money. Must be 18. This is a worldwide giveaway. So if it reaches your country and there's duties, taxes, or fees, or any of that kind of stuff due, it's on you. Okay? Once it leaves my hands, I'm done with it. Let's see. Got to be 18. You must be a public subscriber. I require that. Give this thumbs up some thumbs. Give it some love. If you share me out, cool. You don't have to, but, you know, share me out. I would like that. And I'm going to have a keyword. Let's see. Let me show you what's in the giveaway. Then I'll do keyword. It's been a minute. Okay. Let me pull this out first. Okay, this is one of those handy dandy yarn bags that I got from Hobby Lobby. And it has pockets right here in the front. It's drawstring. The inside of it is like a plastic, so it's water resistant. Kind of a cool motif on that fabric, which is really cool. I threw some of those wooden tags that you can put on your projects, or you know, you put your name on them, or made by, or made with love, whatever you want to put on. I have wood burned these. I have painted them. I have wrote on them, you know, just with a marker or pen. So that's going in. Also, I have so much of this, y'all. It came in all the mystery boxes that I bought. Yarnspirations Burnet Satin. It is 200 yards, 100% acrylic. 4 medium, requires a 5 millimeter hook. Don't iron, don't bleach. You can wash and dry it. The color is lavender. And I'm putting 4 skeins in there. That's 800 yards. You know, that's enough to make a pretty good dent in a project. And let me see if I can get it all in here and show you what else. And okay. And I got this pom-pom that I thought went pretty good with that yarn. I thought that would be a pretty, like, you know, make yourself a hat and scarf. There's plenty enough in there for a hat and scarf. Or make yourself a pocket, hooded pocket scarf, you know, and put a pom-pom on top. You could do that, too, with it. Got plenty enough yarn to do that. So let me see. What am I going to make the keyword? Let's make the keyword pom-pom. No. Scratch that. We're going to make the keyword lilac. Because, well, it said lavender, but I said lilac and wrote that down. So, I don't know if I want you to... No, we're going with pom-pom. I don't want people to misspell. P-O-M. P-O-M. So, the keyword is pom-pom. You know, try to inconspicuously, put that in a sentence. Good luck with that, right? And that'll enter you in the giveaway. And like I said, all the other rules, if I forgot anything, are down below in the description box. I'm going to end this one on the 25th. Like I said, the rules and all that will be in the description box. Now, what I'm going to do here is, today is Monday the 15th. Tomorrow at 1 p.m., I'm live with Crystal on Crystal the Yarny Chicken Crazy Cat Ladies channel at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's 12 o'clock for her, so I think that's, might be Central Time. I'm not sure. And so that's what I got coming up. Also, too, I have a hidden giveaway in another one of my videos prior. And that's getting picked on the 18th. And then, of course, I've got my live on Saturday at 6 p.m. And that's it for this upcoming week. So live with Crystal tomorrow at 1 p.m. Worldwide giveaway that was hidden in one of my videos on the 18th. And the 20th is live at 6 p.m. And we're going to have some fun. I hope you'll be there. Okay. Did I discuss everything I wanted to discuss today? Yeah. I think it did. Okay. So, I guess that's it for now. I'll see you guys soon. I'm going to be doing a yarn tour of my room because I rearranged my yarn room. And so be watching out for that. I don't know, next couple days or so. Got a few things going on. Like I said, I got Crystal at 1. Maybe I'll do sometime in the evening. I don't know. But next couple days, I'll give you a tour of the yarn room. And also, too, I'll be picking that other hidden winner giveaway. Wow. I'm tired, I think. All right, y'all. Well, let me get this clicker. I got the old clicker, so you know how that works. All right, so that's what's going on with me this week. Put in the comments what you're working on. I'm curious to know. What's everybody working on? It's like right in between summer and fall. So it's like, are you still continuing to make summer? Or are you getting a head start on your fall? You know, I always wonder that around this time of year. It's like, should I get started on my fall? But I don't want no blankets, even though I'm doing the baby blanket, but it's small. And, you know, I don't want no blankets laying on me or, you know, bulky yarn because it's hot. You know, how do you guys feel about it? I mean, this time of year, what is it that you work on? Are you still working on summer? Or are you moving in towards fall? Let me know. I'm just kind of curious because I'm trying to pick out another project after baby stuff, you know. You know, because I'll have this, I'm going to do them a sweater and some booties and a hat and whatever. But, you know, a week I'll have it done. So then what? You know, that's how I end up. Well, as soon as I finish this, I'm going to, and I got to figure it out. So let me know what you're doing. You know, are you doing fall stuff? Are you doing more summer stuff? Whatever. And don't forget to read the rules below. And I love y'all. I'll see ya. See if this works. Nope, this one doesn't like me.